Hello everyone, let us solve a few more problems on simply supported beam by Castiglione's method. We have solved a few problems on cantilever beam, finding the deflection problems by Castiglione's. So this is with respect to simply supported beam by Castiglione's method. So here it is required to find the deflection at point C. So this is point C. So they are asking us to find what is delta C. So as per Castiglione's theorem, so we need to have a concentrated load about the point where the deflection is required. So here there is a concentrated load or a point load. So but we will first consider that load as P. In terms of P, we need to find what is the moment. Then we need to differentiate that moment with respect to P. Then before integration, after differentiation, we are going to set P as 60 kN. Okay, so here this is the simply supported beam wherein the bending moment will not be constant throughout A to B. So we need to split into AC region and CB region. We need to have two regions. Okay, so since the bending moment will be different in both the regions, since concentrated load came into picture here, correct? So since we are considering this load P, okay, so we need to have this reactions first in terms of P. So since it is a symmetrical load, so the reactions will share this load equally, correct? So ultimately reactions will be total load divided by 2. So it is 60 by 2, 30 kN, 30 kN, but we are finding in terms of P. So it will be P by 2, P by 2. So this reaction is P by 2. Even this reaction R is P by 2. Since it is a symmetrical load, so the reactions will be equal divided by 2. Correct? So total load divided by 2. Both the supports will share this particular load, correct? So 2 meters from point B, it is 2 meters. So we need to have one section here, one more section here. So in a CB region, B as the origin, and this is the section at a distance x. In AC region, A as the origin, so we need to have the section xx at a distance x from point A, correct? So similar to strain energy method, whatever we have solved the problem, so the same thing I have shown here. So first I will assume this 60 kN as P. The reactions will be P by 2, and this is P by 2. A as the origin, at a distance x the section, I need to have the bending moment. So what will be the moment here? So it is P by 2 into x, correct? So Px by 2. So similarly this side also it is Px by 2. That will be the moment. In AC region also same, in CB region also it is same. So that only I have written here, portion AC, portion BC. So in AC region, so A as the origin, in BC region B as the origin. So when you come across the moment of inertia, so they have not given anything, so we can consider it as constant. So moment of inertia is constant, for that reason I have not put here. So if you want, you can put one more tabular column where moment of inertia is I. So origin is A, so in BC region origin is B, limits 0 to 2. AC region of span 2 meters, BC region of span 2 meters, correct? So then moment in AC region, that is reaction into x. So what is sign convention? Cut a section. So left hand side, if it is clockwise, positive. From right hand side, if it is anti-clockwise, positive. So here, cut a section left, you are considering. So it is making clockwise. So P by 2, it is positive. Similarly, cut a section in BC region, so right hand side, so reaction is making the moment at a distance x, it is anti-clockwise according to the sign convention, so it is positive. So P by 2 into x, correct? So p by 2 into x, p by 2 into x. So differentiate with respect to load p. So it will be x by 2, x by 2. So now I need to have this Castiglione's theorem according to number 1. So this and this, I need to write the expression for both the regions separately. For AC region separately, for BC region separately. M into dou m by dou p by ei into dx for AC region. M into dou m by dou p by ei into dx for BC region, because moment will be different. Okay. So if I substitute the values, so limit is 0 to 0 to 2 in both the regions, p by 2 into x, p by 2 into x moment, and differentiation of moment is x by 2, x by 2. It is same. So it is nothing but 2 times 0 to 2, the same thing, p by 2 into x by 2 divided by ei into dx. Okay, so 0 to 2 limit 2 times ultimately. Okay, now what I need to do before integration, I need to set this p as 60. After differentiation, but before integration, I need to set p as 60. So if I substitute 60, this is 2, and here remaining is 30. So 30 into x by 2. So even I can cancel this 2, this 2. So remaining is 30 into x. So that only I have written, 30 into x divided by this ei, 30 by ei. So x is there, integration of x within the limit 0 to 2. What is the so here x into x, so it will be x square is remaining. So integration of x square is x cube by 3 within the limit 0 to 2. Okay, substitute the limits. So again here in this problem, so they have given already the flexural rigidity in standard unit, so that is in kilonewton meter square ei. Okay, if it is mentioned, you need to substitute. So 30 by ei, so whatever the answer you are getting after substitution of these limits, then if you divide it by ei, so you are going to get the deflection as 5 into 10 raised to minus 3 meters. Okay, so this is the problem. So deflection at point C, okay, they have asked. So here you will be getting ultimately 5 into 10 raised to minus 3. So after substitution of this flexural rigidity, this is how you are going to do the simply supported beam problem. So similar to strain energy method, so we need to have two regions, AC region and CB region. Cut a section in AC region, consider A as the origin. Cut a section in BC region, consider B as the origin. Find out what will be the moment. Then, so if load is given, so assume it as P. In terms of P only, we need to find the moment. So after differentiation, before integration, set P is equal to whatever the value is given. So this is how you need to do it. Similarly, one more type of problem where the concentrated load is not exactly at the center. It is not a symmetrical load. So from point A, it is at a distance of 4 meters. From point B, it is at a distance of 2 meters. So again, here it is required to find the deflection at point C. So here, yes. So first condition, whether there is a concentrated load or a point load acting at point C. Yes, here there is a concentrated load of 60 kN acting at point C. So whenever you come across this, so first thing is you need to assume that concentrated load as point P. So in terms of P, find what is reaction RA and what is reaction RB. So in terms of P, so how you find the reaction, you need to use your equilibrium conditions. So if you take moment about B equal to 0, RA into 6 minus P into 2, so you will be getting what is RA. Then if you apply sigma V equal to 0, you will be getting what is RB. So if you find that, so here I have assumed 60 kN as point P. So reactions RA, you will be getting P by 3. So RB, you will be getting 2P by 3. Okay, these are the reactions RA and RB for P load acting at a distance 4 meters and 2 meters from support A and support B. So since we need to have two regions, AC region and CB region separately, find out the bending moments in each region with respect to the reactions in terms of P. Okay, so what will be the moment here at a distance x? P by 3 into x here. So 2p by 3 into x here. So this is the section. So at a distance x, p by 3 into x, 2p by 3 into x in both the regions. Both the moments will be positive, from leftwards clockwise, from rightwards anticlockwise. So it is the sign convention positive. So you are getting the same thing. It is making clockwise, this is making anticlockwise, from rightwards and leftwards. They are according to the sign convention, both will be positive. So portion AC, portion BC. In AC region, A as the origin. In BC region, B as the origin. Limits. So AC region is of span 4 meters, 0 to 4. BC region is of span 2 meters, so 0 to 2. 0 to 4, 0 to 2. So moment in AC region, P by 3 into X. Here 2P by 3 into X. P by 3 into X, 2P by 3 into X. So now we need to differentiate with respect to P. The moment differentiation with respect to P. So here it will be X by 3. So here it will be 2 by 3 into X. You are differentiating with respect to P. Okay. So the same Castiglione's formula you need to have for AC region separately, for BC region separately. So you need to add them. So like principle of superposition for the entire structure. So you will be getting. So 0 to 4, 0 to 2, M into dou M by dou P. So M into dou M by dou P. So again, before integration, we need to set P as 60 here. This P as 60 kilonewton. Okay, so after substitution of 60, integrate it. So you will be getting, so at the end here also they have given the flexural rigidity value, the 16,000 kilonewton meter square. Okay, so however the 60 is constant, it will not be changing. So only in case of the concentrated load, if not there at the point where you are finding the deflection, that time here you need to make it as a zero. So here, however, P is constant, the load 60 you are substituting. So P is nothing but here 60. Either you keep in terms of P only or else it is 60. So 96 into 60 by 27 EI. So 4 into 60 by 9 EI. Okay. So either you substitute 60 here only or else in terms of P at the end, if you can find the what is the P or substitution ultimately answer, so that is also okay. Okay, so here P in terms of P only they have calculated at the end, here they have substituted P as 60, 96 into 60 divided by 27. So EI is given 16,000 kilonewton meter square standard. So if you do it, so the deflection at point C you are getting 213 into 10 raised to minus 3 meters. Okay, so this is the deflection at point C. So this problem is when the load is unsymmetrical. Okay, the procedure remains same. So now expression for maximum deflection. So here the simply supported beam, okay, so it is subjected to uniformly distributed load of intensity W kilonewton per meter. Okay, W kilonewton per meter intensity UDL, so of span L. Okay, so again we need to find the maximum deflection. So where the maximum deflection will be? So in simply supported beam subjected to symmetrical load, so whenever you come across the symmetrical load and the simply supported beam, the maximum deflection will be exactly at the center. Okay, so where you are getting the maximum deflection, so assume the load that is concentrated load P, Okay, so here the load is not there, the constant load exactly at the center, but we are assuming it. So this load is what? Now it is fictitious load or dummy load or imaginary load. Okay, so ultimately after finding the moment, then we need to make it zero before integration. That we need to keep it in mind. Okay, in terms of P, I will find the reactions. So this is P is also symmetrical load, W that is W kiloton per meter, UDL is also symmetrical load. So this P is exactly acting at the center, total span is L. So these reactions will be same, the total load divided by 2. The both the supports will resist these loads equally, that is total load by 2. Correct, RA is total load is how much? W into L, that is for UDL. Total load, P is the concentrated load. So W into L plus P, total load divided by 2 will be the reactions. So each reaction will be shared by the total load divided by 2. So W into L plus P divided by 2. Correct. So total load acting on this beam is for UDL, W into L for the entire span plus P. So total load divided by 2. That is RA and RB. Okay, so then cut a section from A, consider this as A as the origin in AC region. So if you want to find, so again CB region, so cut a section at a distance XB as the origin, find the moment. Okay, so what will be the moment about this point? So R due to RA, W into L plus P divided by 2 into X. Okay, so sign convention clockwise. So RA is making clockwise moment about this section, W into L plus P by 2 into X. But even UDL is there. This UDL is rotating how? So it is rotating anti-clockwise. So what is the moment about this section? W into X by 2. Correct? W into the distance is X, W into X into X by 2. So the here the total load into X by 2 from the center. So due to UDL, W X square by 2. Similarly this side. So moment W L plus B by 2 into X at a X section. Then UDL is there. What is that? So again it is rotating now clockwise, so it is minus W into X into X by 2, the same thing, W X square by 2, this is minus, so here also it is minus W X square by 2. Correct. So AC region, BC region, in origin A, origin B, so limits 0 to L by 2, 0 to L by 2, moment of inertia is constant II, so moment W into L plus P by 2 into X. Okay, so this is into X, so total I forgot to write here into X. So again here the W X square by 2 into X. Okay, so if you simplify this, so X, if you expand this, you will be getting correct answers. Okay, so here W L plus P by 2 into X minus W into X by 2, W X square by 2. Okay, W X square by 2, W L plus P by 2 into X. Okay, so this is wrong. Okay, similarly here into X. Okay, W L plus P by 2 into X. Then minus W X square by. Okay, this has to be something like this. Okay, so dou m by dou p, so with respect to p, so what is the term remaining here? P, if you open x by 2, only the p term associated here is px by 2. So differentiation with respect to p is x by 2. So x by 2, so here also x by 2. Okay, so for AC region, for BC region, substitute the values, then limits, then substitute P is equal to 0. Okay, so substitute p is equal to 0. So this, if you need to substitute 0, so ultimately expression you will be getting, so delta deflection at the midspan will be 5 w l raised to 4 divided by 384 ei. So 5 w l raised to 4 divided by 384 ei. This is standard. Okay. So expression for maximum deflection, so you will be getting 5 w l raised to 4 divided by 384 ei. Okay, this is the maximum deflection for simply supported beam subjected to UDL. Okay, similarly one more problem, though this is a cantilever beam where moment of inertia are changing. Okay, so when moment of inertia are changing, so again A to B one region, B to C one more region, because A to B it is 2i, B to C it is i, so you are finding the moment and also the in expression. So m into dou m by dou p divided by ei, the flexural rigidity terminology is there. Okay, so for that reason we need to split into two regions, AB as one region and BC as one more region. Okay, so in BC cut a section from free end, this is x. In BA, so consider B as the origin at a distance x. Okay, so in BC region C as the origin, in AB region B as the origin. Okay, find what will be the moment. So here the deflection is required at point C, so delta C. So first check whether there is a concentrated load acting at point C. Yes, there is a concentrated load acting at point C. So assume this concentrated load as P. Okay, assume this concentrated load as P. So in terms of P, find what is the moment in this region. Find what is the moment in this region. So just check it. In BC region, what will be the moment? So cantilever beam, cut a section rightwards, anti-clockwise positive, but this is making clockwise, correct? So it is rotating clockwise. So P into X, so minus PX. Minus PX will be the moment in BC region. So in AB region, so minus P into 1 plus X up to this point due to this P. This is the total perpendicular distance from here to here. P into 1 plus X. So which is rotating clockwise, so it is minus. Minus P into 1 plus X is the moment about this. Then again UDL is there. So for that UDL, 30 into X by 2. So here, concentrated 30 into X is the total load into X by 2. This is the perpendicular distance, 30 into X by 2. So that will be the moment. So that only. So in BC region, at a distance x, C as the origin, cut a section. So assume this 10 kN as P. Okay. So then in BA region, so it is P into 1 plus X. So from here to here it is 1. From here to here it is X. Total will be 1 plus X, P into 1 plus X. Then for this UDL, only from here to here, 30 into X by 2. Check here, BC region, BA region. So AB, BC, BC, BA. Okay, C origin, B origin, C origin, B origin. Limits, so this is 1 meters, 0 to 1, 0 to 2, 0 to 1, 0 to 2. Okay, moment of inertia, it is changing. So here in BC region, it is I. In, so here, yes, BA region, it is 2I. So BC region, it is I, and BA region, it is 2I. So moment in BC region, P into X minus PX, correct? So here it will be P into 1 plus X, then 30 into X by 2, minus P into 1 plus X, minus 30 into X by 2, nothing but, so 30 divided by 2 X square, 30 divided by 2 is nothing but 15 X square, correct? So this, so differentiate with respect to P, so differentiation of minus px with respect to p is minus x. So similarly here, this term will be 0 for this if you open the bracket. So p plus px, correct? So or else directly the coefficient of p will be minus 1 plus x, correct? This is the differentiation of moment with respect to p. So two regions for BC region separately. So this is for BC region. So this expression for BA region, correct? So this is for BC region. So this is for BA region. So m into dou m by dou p divided by ei into dx. M into dou m by dou p into dx divided by ei for both the regions. Okay. So now set p equal to 0. Set p is equal to 0. Correct. So you will be getting at the end. So the deflection, it is 96.67. We need to set p is equal to 0. No, sorry. So p is given, that is 10 kiloton. Okay, so set. So what we need to set this p as whatever the value, 10 kiloton. Set p as 10 kiloton. Here also set p as 10 kiloton. Either you set here only, or else after integration you can set p equal to 10 kiloton. So you will be getting the value as 96.67 by ei. Okay, so this is the deflection. Similarly, one more type of problem, so by cantilever beam only, where it is required to find deflection at point B. So just now we have found the deflection at point C here. So now we need to find deflection at point B, but here there is no concentrated load acting at point B. Okay, so if it is not there, what we need to do? So we need to assume a dummy load or a fictitious load, correct? Dummy load or fictitious load. Okay, then same, cut a section, this is x, cut a section, this is x. So that only we have written. So from C the x, from B the x. Okay, so here I have written it is wrong. So x should be from here. Okay, so this is not there. From point B it is x, from point C it is x. So what is the moment in BC region? 10 into x. So here t into x, then again 30 into x into x by 2, both are negative. So minus 10 into x in CB region, minus px minus 30 into x into x by 2 means minus 15x square, correct? So BC region, BA region, origin C, origin B, origin C, origin B, 0 to 1, 0 to 2. So this is of span 1 meters, this is span of 2 meters. Moment of inertia I and 2i. So this is I, this is 2i. So moment. So in BC region, minus 10 into x, this is 10 into x. Here it is minus 10 into 1 plus x, minus 10 into 10 into 1 plus x. So up to here, then again minus px, correct? Sorry, due to this minus px, then due to 30, that is 30 into x by 2. So this is x square. Okay, minus 15 x square. So dou m by dou p, so differentiate with respect to p. So here p term is not there, so 0. Here the p term is there here, so minus x. Okay, so for BC region, for BA region, m into dou m by dou p into dx divided by ei. So be careful with this ei. So for BC region it is I, for BA region it is 2i. Okay, that you need to take care. So then p set equal to 0 because you have assumed the value. So then simplify, do the integration. After differentiation, before integration, set p as 0. So here the value of ei is given, that is 6300 kiloton meter square in standard units. So you will be getting 53.33 by EI delta. So EI, if you all substitute the value, so the deflection you are getting 8.465 into 10 raised to minus 3 meters. Okay. So in previous lecture, we have found the slopes. The slopes will be in radians. The deflection will be in meters. Okay. So the slopes will be in radians. Similarly, one more type of problem. So wherein simply supported beam subjected to concentrated load with varying moment of inertias. Okay. So this is a problem of simply supported beam wherein moment of inertia is changing. From A to B, it is I. From B to C, it is 2I. A to B, it is I. From B to C, it is 2I. So find the deflection at point B. So here, so yes, there is a concentrated load. So if concentrated load is there, so you need to assume it as P. So in terms of P, find out the reactions. So it is symmetrical load, so directly it is P by 2, correct? See, if it is symmetrical load, A to B it is 4 meters, B to C it is 4 meters, but moment of inertia is changing. So but distance, it is exactly at the center, so it is symmetrical load. So the reactions will be same, total load divided by 2. Both the supports have to share the load equally. So P by 2, you are assuming P, reaction is P by 2, AB is one region, BC is one more region. So this is X, the section from A, we need to consider A as the origin in AB region, the section XX at from C, C as the origin. Okay, what is the moment at this section? So it is P by 2 into X plus, since it is clockwise, sign convention, cut a section, clockwise, anti-clockwise. So here it is clockwise plus, here it is anti-clockwise plus P by 2 into X. Okay, AB region, BC region, A as the origin, C as the origin. Limits 0 to 4, 0 to 4. Moment of inertia I and 2I. So please be careful with this. So moment is px by 2. The differentiation of moment with respect to p, partial derivative will be x by 2. Okay, so this is for AB region and this is for BC region. Okay, so be careful with this. So BC region is of moment of inertia 2i, so it will be 2ei. So m into dou m by dou p into dx, m into dou m by dou p into dx, so divided by ei. Okay, so here we have assumed, so 60 kilonewton as p. So now either you substitute here only, or else in terms of p do it, then later you can substitute. So here we have substituted p as 60, so do this integration. Okay, 60 by 4 into x square integration is x raised to 3 by 3. So do that, so substitute the limits. So ultimately you will be getting the deflection at point C, that is 480 by EI. Okay, so that is 480 by EI, that will be the deflection. Okay, these are the some of the problems with respect to cantilever beam and simply supported beams by Castiglione's theorem. Similarly, we need to now solve the problems on frames. What is frame? A frame is a structure with column and beams. Two columns, a beam, only one column, a beam. Okay, so this is a frame where column is there and beam is there. So again, here we need to have the deflections. Okay, so when you come across the frames, so usually a question will be, you need to find the deflection which is vertical and which is horizontal. You need to have the vertical displacement and horizontal displacement sometimes. So if you are finding the vertical displacement, the load should be acting in the direction of vertical displacement only. If you are finding horizontal displacement, the load should be acting in the direction of horizontal only. That you need to take care of. So here it is asked to find the vertical displacement at A. So delta, so I'll be writing VA. So what is this VA? So deflection at point A, which is vertical. So vertical means yes. So there is a load which is acting vertical in y-axis. Okay. So these are the spans they have given. BC span is H in terms of H. BA span is A. Okay. So already we solved such type of problems in strain energy methods. The same approach we are finding here. Okay, so here what we need to do, so in obviously in frames, in column and beams, the moment will be changing. So whenever you come across the column and beam, so you will be cutting the section and you will be assuming the distance x from the origin. So usually it is better, so we will not touch this, because if you want to touch this from this end, if you want to find the section C as the origin, then we should be knowing what will be the reactions at this point. Okay, so always it's better to start with the free end. So from A, consider the section and A as the origin at a distance x, find what is the moment in BA portion. Okay, so one more is BC portion. So from B as the origin, and this is x. Okay, so then what will be the moment in BC region? So if you consider support this as x, then we should be knowing what will be these reactions. This is vertical, horizontal, and a moment. All the three reactions first we need to find, correct? So it's better instead of this, so we'll go ahead with this free end, so directly we can find what will be the moments. Okay, so here in BC region there is no additional load acting, and in BA region also there is no load. So exactly the point A vertical deflection required, and there is a point force P which is acting at point A. So it's not necessary to assume again. So the intensity is only P they have given, the same thing. So P they have given. So cut a section from A as the origin x, cut a section, this section from B as the origin y, or else you can say x. Here also x, here also x, no problem. Here I have used y, so both are same at a distance x, at a distance phi. So h and a as the spans. So portion AB, so this is portion AB, a as the origin, moment. So again same convention from rightwards, so anticlockwise positive, but this is clockwise. So it is minus p into x, minus p into x, moment of inertia is I. In both the regions it is I only. So limits 0 to A. So from 0 to A. So 0 to A. A origin is A. So if you differentiate with respect to load P, so you will be getting minus x. Correct? So similarly in portion BC. So the portion BC is here. Okay. So again, what will be the moment at this point? Okay, the load is here. So force into perpendicular distance. So the moment about this point, it will be, this is the line of action of force, it is a straight line. Okay, just a minute. Yeah, this load is moving like this, correct? So you are finding moment here. So this will be the perpendicular distance. So this is x if you consider. Okay, but here it is already given, it is A. Perpendicular distance is A. Okay, so the load is P. So what is the moment about this point? P into A. It is rotating again clockwise. If it is anticlockwise positive, but since it is rotating clockwise, P into A, minus P into A. So minus P into A. So dou m by dou P. So with respect to P, it is minus A. So this is again same. So m into dou m by dou p into dx by ei. So m into dou m by dou p into dy by ei. So since I have assumed as y, so I am writing dy. So if you assume this one also x, so you can write it as dx only. Okay. So within the limits, do this, integrate it. So but before this p, okay, so usually you will substituting 0 or else whatever the value is there you will substitute, but p here is p only, correct? So this is p only, okay, keep it in mind. So p only they have given, so p only, it is p only. So in other problems we have substituted as 0 if you have assumed an imaginary load, or else we have substituted the value, numerical value, if it is given. Okay, after integration, after substitution of your limits, so you will be getting delta as p a square into a plus 3h divided by 3ei. Okay, this is to find vertical deflection, where vertical load is required, so we need to have the vertical deflection. Similarly, suppose the same problem, if you want to find the horizontal deflection at point A, okay, but the load is acting vertical, so we are finding the horizontal deflection. So if you want to find the horizontal deflection, so what we require, so we require the horizontal load which is acting at point A. Okay, so this horizontal load is required. So what we need to do, so we need to assume a horizontal load of intensity Q. How we are assuming the P, so if you want to find the horizontal displacement or deflection, we need to have the horizontal load, and this intensity is Q, horizontal load of Q. Okay, then section is same in BA portion, A as the origin, this, yeah, so we are having two loads, one is P and one more is Q, so where the horizontal load is required. So what we'll do, so cut a section and moment in BA region is, so due to this Q, what is the moment at this point, so it is zero because there is no perpendicular distance, it is acting in the line of action of the point where we are finding the moment, correct, due to P, yes, it is P into X in BA region. Similarly in BC region, so what will the moment, so this is the line of action of force, this is Q and perpendicular distance this, so it is rotating clockwise, so it is Q into Y, correct, so due to P it is P into this A, correct, so the same thing. So in AB region, so only due to P will be the moment at point this, so that will be P into X, so minus P into X. Similarly in a BC region, so in BC region, so due to Q, so this Q into perpendicular distance Y, Q into Y, so that is minus Q into Y, since it is clockwise. Similarly due to P, this is the line of action of force and this will be the perpendicular distance, that is A, P into A, so that is minus P into A since it is clockwise, correct. So then dou M by dou P, so due to differentiation in AB region, so it will be 0, so here it will be minus Y. Okay, so actually, so here you are finding the deflection with respect to horizontal, so horizontal deflection at A, so here it should be dou M by dou Q. Okay, so there is a slight change in this. Okay, make a note of this. So you need to have the differentiation with respect to Q, since you are finding the horizontal. So here, since you are finding the horizontal with respect to Q, the Q term is not there, so differentiation of this moment will be 0. So here minus Q Y is there, so differentiation of this term will be minus Y. So this is for AB region. Okay, this is for BC region. So what will be the equation here, m into dou m by dou q into dx, Okay, so here m into dou m by dou q into dy, correct? So substitute the values within the limits, do this, you will be getting delta as p h square into a divided by 2ei. Okay, so I hope it is clear. So once again check this. So you are finding the horizontal displacement. So since there is no horizontal load, first you will assume a horizontal load of q. So this is the section. Okay, so moment in AB portion will be due to q, there is no perpendicular distance. So this is x due to p, p into x is there, correct? So that minus px. Then in BC region, so this is the section, this is y you are assuming. So due to q, so this is load is moving like this clockwise, q into y. Okay, since it is clockwise, minus, correct? Cut the section if it is anti-clockwise, plus, but it is rotating clockwise, so minus qy due to p. So this is the line of action of force, so this will be the perpendicular distance, which is a. So p into a, so it is rotating again clockwise, so minus p into a, minus pa minus qy. So you need to differentiate with respect to q, not p. So I have written p, please make a note. So it should be differentiated with respect to q. So you'll be getting minus q here, 0 here. So the equation will be m into dou m by dou q into dx, m into dou m by dou q into dy for AB region, for BC region. So substitute after differentiation, before integration, you need to set this q as 0. Do not forget this q as 0. Because we are assuming this, it is an dummy load, imaginary load. Okay, so once you substitute and do this integration, you will be getting the displacement as p h square into a divided by 2ei. Okay, so I hope it is clear. We'll solve a few more problems on frames in next class. Thank you.